said Morgan, flinging down his paintbrush.
"For that, let's blow,"
said Morgan, and he bolted out of the house without even waiting to put on his coat. Something up above was calling him into the sunlight and away, across the meadows and along the copses, trotting along the riverbank, where all of a sudden he sat down, entranced and bewitched. As he sat on the grass and looked across the river, he became aware of a bright little star winking at him from the opposite bank. The star became an eye, and then there was another eye, then a small brown face with whiskers.
Hello, Mo.
Hello,
I was just going off for a trip on the river. Would you like to come? Come on, old chap, just step into the boat. Now you really are afloat. Picnic hamper under your seat. Sit back, relax, there'll be plenty to eat.
Spent the summer and the autumn showing Mole the sights of the riverbank and introducing him to all his friends, except for one, the rather grumpy Mr. Badger, who lived in the wild wood.
"Couldn't we invite him to dinner?"
asked Mole.
"He wouldn't come," said Rat.
"Simply hates society."
"Well then, why don't we go and call on him?"
suggested Mole.
"It's a long journey,"
replied Rat.
"But perhaps we should pay him a visit, especially as Christmas is coming on."
And so one cold December day, they set off through the wild wood, rather thoughtfully.
That moment sees.
it's us, rat and mole.
Why come in, my fortune of those confounded field mice carol singing again. Come in, and sit by the fire.
We wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas.
Oh, confound you, wretched field mice, I suppose you'd better come in. For the moment, be silent while I talk with Mr. Rat and Mr. Mole. Now tell me, dear Rat, what is the news of the outside world? And in particular, what of our reckless young friend, Mole?
There's nothing new about the toad, except his latest crazes.
Alike, our crazy foolish crazes.
There is no end to what he'll find, his stamina amazes.
Amazes?
I blame his parents, such well-intentioned folk, but then alas they spoiled him.
I fear they must have spoiled him.
It's a problem, it's a problem, it's a terrible, terrible problem. It's a problem, it's a problem, it's a terrible, terrible problem. We'll have to do something about Mr. Toad, his conduct is truly appalling. He's foolish and fickle and easily led. A seat to your boastful and weak in your head. You'll go to the bad and then soon you'll be dead. What can we do to prevent it from falling?
Last month he bought a gypsy caravan in bright canary yellow.
No, not bright canary yellow.
The colour's jolly bad enough, but worse was soon to follow.
Alack,
I think that Oxford did for him.
Too true, indeed.
All those aesthetic parties.
I disapprove of parties.
A dancer's song is true, a birdie balls and parties.
Hold your tongue,
it's a problem. It's a problem, it's a terrible, terrible problem. It's a problem, it's a problem, it's a terrible, terrible problem.
We had to do something about Mr. Toad. This time is truly appalling. He's foolish and fickle and easily led. He's seated and boastful and weak in the head. He'll go to the bad and then soon he'll be dead. What can we do to prevent him from falling?
This month, I think you must have heard, it's motor cars and speeding at more. 20 miles an hour. His reckless fury as he drives to tragedy is leading.
How true.
The countryside is now no longer safe. His motor rings a menace.
A grandma says.
Shush.
We'll have to do something about Mr. Toad. His conduct is truly appalling. He's foolish and fickle and easily led. He's seated on most of the moon in the head. We'll go to the band and then soon we'll be dead. What shall we do?
What should 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 we do?
We'll set him out, we'll cut him right, we'll set him straight, we'll lecture him, we'll get him on the rails and mash him up and fall as bad. Yes, that's what we'll do.
Returned home the next day, determined to save Toad from the dreadful consequences of his new motor craze. The rest of the winter passed quietly. One morning, quite early in the spring, all three animals happened to be standing in a peaceful lane near the riverbank when they heard a most terrible commotion in the distance.
Ha! Ha!
Sternly.
Toad, you unhappy creature.
Me unhappy?
Exclaimed Toad.
What a lot of rot you talk, Badger. I'm the happiest creature alive. The open road, the smell of hot oil. If you chaps can't recognize the coming thing when you see it, then I'm afraid progress won't wait for you, and neither shall I. Must be off. See you chaps at my place in time.
And with that, Toad started up the car again and drove off. That wasn't the end of it, as I'm afraid we'll see.
Silence! Silence in court!
And downcast was led away roughly by two horny-handed jailers and thrown into the nastiest of jungle, dungeons, with nothing for company save the occasional spider, but no solace save that provided by a tin mug of brackish water and stale crust thrown to him from time to time. And oh, I nearly forgot, the rather comely and kind-hearted daughter of one of the jailers. Let us eavesdrop as she attempts to rally the starving and disconsolate felon.
Let me tickle your fancy toes. Nice boy.
Alas, nothing the jailer's daughter had to offer seemed to rouse him. But, like all great men of history, his single-mindedness saw him through, and he escaped by exchanging clothes with a humble washerwoman. Let us join him as he makes his way back to Toad Hall, a sadder and wiser toad. Actually, that's not quite true, but perhaps I'll let you be the judge of that. Here he is.
With cudgels,
with cudgels,
and with pistols of alarming aspect. suspect. Gain entry to Toad Hall by a secret tunnel, the presence of which was fortunately made known to me by Toad's august father many long years ago.
Aha!
Then we advance upon the weasels and the ferrets and the snakes, brandishing our weapons and singing a ferocious and blood-curdling chorus. That's right, with solos by Toad. The weasels, the ferrets, and the stoats will all flee in abject and mortal terror. Comrades, advance.
Let's wallop a weasel, let's strangle a stoat, let's frazzle a ferret or two, have them by the throat. Twist their arms and pull their necks until their eyes go pop. Toad Hall is Toad Hall, let's go over the top.
Tip-toe up the staircase, tip-toe, tip.
Potter down to the pantry.
Hit, pat, hit.
Back again to the foot of the stairs.
Catch the villains unawares.
Say the patriotic
verses
while they say the prayers.
Let's go over the top. Spear down to the floor. Weasel better and chips is a treat that we adore.
Shrink the stones in little bits.
Let's have a complete shot. It's weasel whacking good. So let's go over the top.
Quack, quack, quack.
Watch it, there goes a weasel.
Quack, 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 splat.
Strike,
yes, it's a got him squashed, him flat.
Fair by the door, there he's lost for peaceful dead.
Yes,
Toad Hall is Toad Hall. Have we taken care of them all? Toad Hall.
Didn't I hear a weasel call?
Come on, let's get out of here.
He's gone over the top.
Ferret and stoat fled in panic and disorder, and Toad Hall was once more Toad's. Badger lectured Toad sternly, reminding him that his folly and his boastfulness had nearly cost him his liberty and his home, and Toad promised to mend his ways. The next night, a celebration banquet was held at Toad Hall, and everyone made merry. It was nearly midnight when Badger rose to his feet, rather unsteadily, and address the assembled company.
My friends, this is a happy occasion. Toad Hall lately fallen into the evil hands of the weasels.
The weasels.
Ferrets.
The ferrets.
The stoats. Rightful honor, I give you a toast of and
home.
And now I call upon our good friend Mr. Toad to make a brief reply.
I could never have come back if it hadn't been for you, my friends. A house can seem empty, so you wander and you think of your friends. There are so many things that I never really saw before, but I think that I can see them clearly now. The kettle on the hall, the chestnuts in the fire, the slippers by the rocking chair, drifting.
it's time that perhaps I started perhaps to think about settling down.
Worth a million motor cars, thought Toad.